Hi everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel. Today we will be discussing The Girl Who Can, which is a short story written by Emma Attaidu. It was included in her collection of short stories ANOVA, published in 1970. Adjoa, a 7-year-old girl, says that she is an African child who was born in the village of Hazordi, which is in a region of Africa that is fairly fertile in comparison to the rest of the continent. She asks naively what social constraints a child, especially a girl, faces when speaking in public. Adjoa, Mami, her mother, and Nana, her grandmother, are the three generations in the story. And because her mind is always thinking about things that are too complex for a girl of her age to understand, they frequently find themselves in a position where they disagree. The father is not in the picture, but there is a little suspicion that he is not a good man or that he may have abandoned them. Nana is authoritative and strongly believes that a woman's role in society is to be physically fit and healthy. On the other hand, Mami, who Nana refers to as Kaya, frequently comes across as a character who lacks emotion and is unable to speak out against her mother. Adjoa is an intricate combination of the two. She has questions about how society works, but she chooses to keep them in the back of her mind for two reasons. First, to keep them from hurting her grandmother, and second, to keep them from becoming jokes. Nana is troubled by Adjoa because of her short legs' inability to support a pregnant woman's figure. Adjoa's physicality goes hand in hand with her social activities, like going to school, which Nana also despises. Mami has moments of bravery when she tries to support Adjoa despite her constant criticism of Adjoa. However, when Adjoa discloses that she has chosen to run for a district office, perceptions shift. Nana's behavior suddenly changes, and she tries to neatly iron and wash her granddaughter's uniform. She travels with Adjoa throughout the entire race week in brand new clothes that she only wears on special occasions. With tears in her eyes, Adjoa shows the trophy around the neighborhood. The story comes to a happy conclusion when Nana and Adjoa realize that a woman uses her legs for more than just giving birth. The roles of mother and wife should not define a woman's identity. In this case, her accomplishments as an athlete should also serve as the foundation. Now, we will be discussing the main themes of The Girl Who Can, written by Emma Attaidu. Number 1. Gender Roles. The story challenges traditional gender roles by depicting a young woman who refuses to conform to the societal expectations of what a woman should be able to do. Second, societal pressure. The story highlights the pressure that Adjoa faces from her community to conform to traditional gendered roles and the stigma that she faces for not being able to fulfill them. Third, independence. The story emphasizes the importance of independence and the pursuit of one's own interests, even if they go against societal norms. Fourth, resilience. Adjoa's determination and resilience in the face of challenges is a central theme of the story. She refuses to let the opinions of others define her and instead focuses on her own goals and ambitions. Fifth, self-belief. The story demonstrates the power of self-belief and the importance of valuing one's own abilities and accomplishments regardless of what others may think or say.